guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you for choosing this video. In this episode, I am going to be sharing with you guys what I learned in this year. I don't know about you, but I did learn so many things and I want to share with you guys because I know for sure that we all learned something this year. This year was a year of many disasters, many sadness, many things. It was a roller coaster, you know, and we definitely had to learn so much from it. A lot of people did took advantage of this, of what's happening, and they embraced what they learned. I also wanted to show you guys, I want to share with you guys what I learned, and I learned so many things, guys. I learned so many things. A year that we had to rethink and rethink of everything. First, I learned that what you plan sometimes doesn't go, because in one instant it could change. And it's true. In the beginning of this year, I had my agenda, you know, I had my agenda that I was gonna do so many things, and nothing happened, right? Because of this pandemic. And it was crazy. It was crazy because I had so many plans. I don't know about you if you did have plans also, right? But yeah, it changed completely. And not only that, when everything started, when I heard the news and everything, I got panic. I was like, what is going on? And I remember that my church was still going on, and I decided not to go. And then they closed 2 weeks or a week after. And then I was like, oh my gosh. You know why? Because I had to learn that I needed to protect myself and protect my family. First my family, then me. And when I protect myself, I could protect my family and I could protect my whole environment. And that's what I did, you know. And I had to learn that. I had to be firm, you know, not to see my parents, you know, because they wanted to see his grandchild. But I was like, no, you can't, you know. And a lot of people, they were like, oh, that's not good, you know, grandchildren, they need to see their grandparents, you know. I know, I understand, but in this thing right now, we cannot underestimate it. And so I had to be firm. I had to learn to be strong and firm in order to protect myself and my family, to be distant, you know, and everything, to use the proper gears and everything. So another thing that I did learn was to save food, guys. I think this is really important, saving food, because if you don't save food, I think when before everything started, I was already piling, you know, in my pantry a lot of cans, you know, things that doesn't expire too quick. But yeah, it really helps, you know, because when everything started, everything shut it down, you know, we just couldn't go buy and stuff like that. And everything was like so sold out, especially the toilet paper, because a lot of people were going crazy with the toilet paper. And so when everything reopened, you know, and they allow us to buy a little bit more, I did buy more and save it, you know, because I think it's really important. So I think that's something that we needed to learn from this year for the next pandemic, you know, because yes, guys, something bad is gonna happen next time, you know, a bigger virus. But I think that what we learn from now is what we need to learn from now is we need to implement it in the next time. Another thing that I had to learn this year was to have more faith in God. That's something that I had to learn more, because if it wasn't because of that, I think I would have completely vanished. I remember I was crying in the beginning, and I was already getting depressed and anxious, like, what is going on? Why is this not going away? And you know, and if it wasn't because of that faith, I think I wouldn't make it. I were not going to make it. You know, a lot of people, they took their life off. They decided to end their life because I don't know what happened to them. But for me, what did help me was to have a little bit more faith on God. And so that really helped me a lot. Another thing that it really helped me was to protect my family against everything. I had to put measures, you know. I had to maintain myself away. I have to like be in maintain, always use my proper gear, my proper use hand sanitizer when I was in the stores, you know. And I don't know if this happened to you, but I was, oh my god, I was touching my face so much, and then I was like, oh my gosh, I just touched my face and I haven't cleaned my hands, you know. And I was like so scared all the time. I don't know if that happened to you, but it was scary. I was like scary. But you know, guys, you know, it happens. And so that I need to learn how to do, you know, to stop touching my face, stop touching my head, my neck or something, because I needed to go home right away to wash myself, you know, clean myself up, and then gather with my family. But it was kind of scary. I don't know if that happened to you, but it was really, really scary. Another thing that I had to learn was to appreciate life, the little things. Like, I don't know if you are a beach lover, but I am. And so we love to go to the beach, we love to go to the park. In the beginning, it was so hard to go because we couldn't like swim, you know. We had to be like, oh, away from everybody, you know. And then because we didn't want to get infected, and or if we had it, we didn't want to infect anybody else. And so it was a little struggle, you know. I was really struggling. So I really appreciate the little things, you know, the little things that we cannot take it for granted. To gather with friends, gather with family, gather in churches, you know, and go to places, like travel, you know. It's really, 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 we take it sometimes for granted, but this time of year, you know, it's really not. We had to evaluate what we missed out in the previous years, you know. I needed time to heal and to rethink on what I did wrong and what I did, you know, what I needed to change for me to heal and for me not to get depressed and for me not to get sad and all that stuff. One of the things that I had to learn in order for me to not do that was to turn off the TV, turn off the news, the fake, the all the news, the fake news, all the stuff, you know. Oh, to not see negative stuff, you know. And my environment needed to be positive, and so that I needed to change all of that. Also, to educate more, you know, to study more, to get more information, to read more. I don't know about you, but there's a lot of information there that we needed to educate and we need to get more in touch with more, because sometimes we say things that we're not supposed to, you know, and we hurt people. And so there's been a lot of hurt already, you know, with people talking really bad stuff, you know, and that's not good. We need to educate ourselves and try to be more humble, more, and be more pacific and be more nicer and caring to others, you know. So I really needed to learn that, and I needed to educate myself more and find this time to study for my NCLEX too. I needed to learn how to limit excuses and use my 24 hours correctly, because previous years I was always with too much work and too much stuff, you know, and I put my stuff, my priorities on the side, and so I was always making excuses, and then I had to learn how to stop making excuses and pull myself into what really matters, you know. And then I decided to work on things that I needed to do and to get my YouTube better than before and to put better content to make this better than before, you know. And so I needed to learn that, you know. And so and not only that, to do exercises, to eat well, you know, to do more that I like to do, that I'm not passionate about. So that is something that I needed to change. One thing that I needed to learn was to stop judge anybody, you know, stop judging everybody. And sometimes we judge, you know, even the little things. We judge this, we judge her, we judge them, we judge them because they post something, but we don't know what they're going through, you know. And sometimes we need to stop judging people, you know, and we stop embracing them. If you don't want to know about them, just skip it, or just go to another YouTube, or just go to another page, you know. But don't judge them because you don't know what they're going through. So that's something that I had to learn this year, that not judging, because you don't know what other people are going through. Another thing that I had to learn was to forget and forgive, because I think that when we do that, we heal better, and we are much better person when we do that. I don't know if you noticed, but there was a lot of people that died without seeing or forgiving or receiving forgiveness, right? Towards their family members or friend or coworker. They died without seeing anybody and without making plans, you know? And so if we are still alive, then we have that opportunity, or if we are in the hospital, let's forgive. Let's call up that person and tell them, hey, I forgive you. During this year, I took my notes and I said to myself, you know what? I'm gonna call this person and I'm gonna ask them for forgiveness. And I did, you know, and it helped me so much, because, and I feel so much better, and I feel so happy, because I was like, you know what? I don't know if I told them something wrong. That happens a lot, that sometimes we hurt someone with our words, and we hurt our family members, and, you know, and we don't want to do that, you know. And so we need to forgive each other in order to become a better person, or to have a better life, you know. Because when you live looking back all the time at what happened or what they did to you, you know, you're not gonna live peacefully. So I think forgiving, forget is super important. Don't look back, just embrace what you have, and rejoice with what you have, and rejoice with your family, with your friends, with your co-workers, and forgive. I think that's really important, because life is too short. Another thing that I had to learn was to gather more with my husband, talk more with my husband. Sometimes we have ups and downs, and that happens to every marriage. And so I think that talk to him more, what he wants, what he would like to do, you know. I think that really unify us more, you know. So that really helped more. I'm really sad that a lot of people didn't make it during this pandemic this year, that during quarantine they split up. I'm really sad for that, you know. I think that during the pandemic we should have been more unified, you know, like more united, but that didn't happen in all cases. It happened to some people, and that's really sad. So yeah, and another thing that I had to learn with all this is that I had to take time for myself. I needed time to say what it really matters to me, what I want for my future, what do I need, what do I would like to do, you know. So taking time for myself, it was really important, and to manage. If you are sitting down and listening to this video, you're probably thinking, what can I do? You know, what I am going to do? Sit and write down, what do you need to change? You know, what do you think, what do you want to change? And, you know, I did that. And so I think that's really important. I think that was really important for me. This year was a big, big lesson for me. And it was really important and to learn, you know. Next year is coming up, and whatever you didn't learn, or whatever you think you didn't learn this year, try to implement it next year, you know. It's never too late. As long we are still alive, it's never too late, you know, for us, and we could just redo everything next year, you know. And so evaluate yourself, evaluate everything that happened, and try to be a better person. I like to see Darman's video because those videos, they just like to change life. And it's true, you know, because when I see the videos, it just motivate me to make a better person. And other videos that I see also in my church, they like to do the same thing. The younger people, they like to like make videos about reflection, and that's amazing. You know, I follow a lot of people in my YouTube channel that they have positive videos. You're gonna see, you could search in my channel where it says channel. Yeah, you're gonna see there all the people that I follow, that they also give a lot of positive, you know. And so they're really great. And so yeah, I definitely encourage you to read more, to encourage, to be more happy, to embrace your life, to embrace the little things that you have, you know, because that's really important, to value them, because you never know, because life is too short. And yeah, life is too short. So yeah, guys, I hope you definitely enjoyed this video. If you learned, I know I learned more things, but I took the most important thing and I created this video. But if you have more thing to share, write it down in the comment down below, because I really want to see what you guys learned this year. I really would like it. And yeah, share this video with someone else. Maybe it will inspire them to just to embrace a little bit more in life, you know. So guys, yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I hope I see you in my next video. Hello guys, thank you for watching. Please don't leave and subscribe for more videos, and give me a thumbs up. If you have any comments, leave them in the box down below. You can also follow me on my social media. Bye for now.